Hey, what's up guys? In this video we'll be reviewing the WiseTiger AC1200M wireless router. So this is a router that supports the standard 802.11ac and has some features and a price tag that I think a lot of people would really enjoy. So let's go ahead and jump into the unboxing and see what comes with it. So it comes in just this brown box. You can definitely tell where the cost savings was with this router. I think it retails for under $50. So definitely undercuts most of the competition, and I think the box, the packaging, and also the materials that the router is made out of is where they were able to lower that cost. So first thing that you get in the box, for some odd reason, is a lightning cable. Has nothing to do with the router. I'm not sure why that was included, but hey, I'll take it. Free lightning cable. We also get a user manual as well as the router itself. So as you can see, it has four antennas. They can all fold in. We'll get to that just a little later. And it also includes a USB flash drive with the owner's manual and some other stuff on there. We'll also get to that a little bit later on. And lastly, in the box, we have the power adapter. So here's some technical specs. 4 gigabit Ethernet ports, 802.11ac, 300 megabits per second on 2.4 gigahertz, and 867 megabits per second on 5 gigahertz. So let's go ahead and get to the setup here. It's just like any other setup with any other router. Go ahead and take an Ethernet cable coming from your modem, plug it into the WAN ports, the odd one out on the back of the router, and then go ahead and plug in the power port. The LED indicator on the front of the router should flash until it gets the internet connection, and then it should be a solid blue color once it's all good to go. So the next step in this process would be to go ahead and connect to the new router. Just go ahead and find a computer or your phone or something and connect to the new Wi-Fi channels, either one, the 5 gigahertz one or the 2.4 gigahertz band, and then there shouldn't be a password, so go ahead and connect to it. Then go to your web browser and go to 192.168.0.1. That's the router's setup page. Type in the password admin, and then this setup page should come up. Now you're going to want to go ahead and find the wireless settings on the left side. Now at this page, you can go ahead and change your Wi-Fi name, add a password, change the wireless channel if you want. Turn the 5 gigahertz band off if you really want. I don't know, just do whatever settings you want. Just note that once you press OK, the settings will change right away. So if you change the name of your Wi-Fi and you press OK, your computer will no longer be connected to that Wi-Fi access point. So you're going to have to go ahead, go back into your Wi-Fi settings and reconnect to it. Just a little FYI. So that USB flash drive we talked about earlier, I went ahead and plugged it in, and it has a couple different things. First is an installation guide video, next is the installation guide, like a PDF file, and then there's a what appears to be a textbook of the geography of China. Kind of threw me off a little bit, not sure why that's on there, but I mean, if you want to learn about the geography of China, that's a pretty easy way. Now they do also have an iPhone app, so you can go ahead and open this up. And what this allows you to do is you can actually sign in to an account, and you can remotely control your Wi-Fi settings, just anything about your Wi-Fi network. Wherever you are, you don't have to be on your home network connected to the router. You can just be wherever you want. You can restart the router, you can test the connection, things like that. This app actually does have a lot of useful tools in it, but there are some problems with it. There's a lot of spelling errors, as you can see, testing spelt wrong. Bandwidth is spelt wrong. A lot of problems, but just minor things. If you know what it's trying to get at, you won't have any problem interpreting it or anything like that. The router itself, the antennas are flexible. You can move them in basically any direction you want, which is really nice. You know, if you have more wireless users on one side of the house, you might want to have the antennas pointing in a certain direction. The only problem, I wish they would have included on the bottom some kind of mounting holes to mount this on the wall. Since the antennas are flexible, you could basically just mount it on the wall and have the antennas spread out like this, which would have been really nice. As far as performance goes, the WiseTiger wireless router is basically on par with any other wireless 802.11ac router, so I was getting very good speeds, especially when I was nearby the router. And as far as distance goes, it was on par, maybe a little less, as far as like how far the router's wireless signal can reach. But I think the typical, you know, modern home, like a family size home, this router will have no problems. But maybe out in the garage, out in, you know, the backyard, front yard, you might get slower speeds or even disconnected at some times. I think this router's online interface is one of its strong suits. It's just really easy to use, really nice layout. You have a lot of nice customizable settings, such as being able to limit the download and upload speeds per device, which is really cool. You can also very easily go ahead and connect the router to an existing network to add it on to the existing network. So what it's doing right now, I chose WISP. It's scanning around, it's finding the different Wi-Fi networks in the area, and I can go ahead and choose my own Wi-Fi network, put in the password, and it'll connect to it and rebroadcast the signal. So you don't even have to have it the router near your modem to plug it in via Ethernet. You can just branch it off of your existing wireless network. That's really nice, and it's very easy to use. The port forwarding settings are also very easy to configure, which is good for gamers. So if you have like a PS4 or an Xbox One, you can easily go and put in the ports that you need, the protocol, and easily just add it onto the list. There's some other settings in here that aren't too important. I don't think things like restricted lists, people probably won't use that too much. But for the most part, I think this router has basically all the settings that just a normal person would need to use on a daily basis. So in summary, I have to say I'm pretty impressed with the WiseTiger wireless router. It has enough bandwidth for everyone in the family to share. It has an online user interface that's easy to use, that you can customize it however you want. And it's just the price. You can't beat the price, especially compared to competitors where you get the same thing for, you know, 2 or 3 times the price of what this is selling for. So it has my recommendation. If you guys want to check it out, I'll have a link in the video description. Thanks for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.